Hello, everyone. I am back online playing Cruncher. I'm your host, Hiroitachi here. And so far, where we're at right now, we are at the Dark Age time period. And we're actually heading to rescue a certain guru that has been sealed. I think it's the reason why I don't like this particular arc, time period, because of these things here. Not this. This is not a boss battle, but this is a regular monster battle. There will be a boss coming further up this part of the dungeon. Not a big fan of it, but we will find out.
I know I shouldn't be using that, but I'm using it anyway.
Get your morphos. Morphos. All right, Rick. Good job. Posing. I guess you're gonna do something about it. Okay. These guys I'm not a big fan of. Boss time. Hate these things. That's a versus a triple raid. That's so bad. He gonna die quick already, what the hell? Alright. Wrong item. That's why you need some time when you don't pay attention to what you're doing. As he woke up, see, this is the reason why I have Robo on the team, because that guy actually, if any non-mechanical characters, the stone in the head would not work very well. So, just saying. Magic phase him pretty well. It's not physical attacks. You know, they might have an item. Let's see if I can heal my guy here. The reason I have her in the team is because not mainly to do damage, but like just do what I'm about to do in a few seconds. I just hope her turn hits quick. All right. Let's hope that my charm skills. She's not charm yet. Shit. Yeah, when they heal like that, let's see. Yeah, I'm doing the same thing too. Yeah. Now she learned charm I would actually obtain a few vests from this particular boss. Yay. 26 tech points. That's not bad. Not bad at all. Very thirsty now. I know she has a long way going, so does Robo, I believe. And a frog, I gotta learn his final tech, so does Chrono himself. I got a long way to go. She's not too far away. That will come in handy once we get to the side quests, because I do want to obtain some items, like the Aussie pants, the flea vest, slasher 2, a couple other equipment as well. If I had Charm a little early, I would have actually went to go get the vests from those particular creatures that we just faced off just now. So don't mind how tired I sound. I'm just got back with some like sad news. Apparently, I called a certain internet provider for information on November 29th, and the operator told me that they did have it, and I hesitated because I read over our lease contract, and then for where we live at, and apparently didn't give me the answer I was looking for, so I'm not too thrilled at that. Not thrilled at all, but we can do. So far, it's not bad. Alright, now the hard monsters to fight here are not what you suspect. It's something that. This thing. Now, the bad thing about this particular creature is going to use a technique that's going to cause you to not use spells. Your accuracy goes really horribly off. And your physical attack doesn't do shit. So, but it has a very low HP. So, see, go lock all. normally if your accuracy was horrible, that would be the problem. So the thing with that is that if you leave the dungeon all the way out and come back up again, they will reappear again. At least I remember playing it back in my emulation years. So this time, I'm not even too sure, folks. So it wouldn't hurt to check, you know, but dead. This part, you shouldn't have no problem getting your tech points to very low with the right characters. So, Dawson. See, very close. I got a long way. I think after Robo's Uzi Punch is supposed to be a more devastating attack afterwards, so we don't know what it is. We will find out eventually. Alright, let's try this one. Gotta kill him fast before, you know, he escapes. And we really don't want him to do that. See? That usually happens. You got limited time to kill him before he runs away. If you don't kill him fast enough, you don't get the tech points. That's the bad thing about that thing. Robo got about another 50 more points now because we just killed that thing. Now, if we able to go back and forth from it and see that thing there again, that'll just prove our chances of actually getting leveling up, but chance of them coming up is pretty low. Respawn rate is pretty low or long, too long. And the bad thing about this dungeon is that once you beat the boss, you don't ever see this dungeon again. So I'll just give you a full spoiler what's going on. That what happens. So see? Long way. There's another area that actually has a similar situation. With those, well, sort of a creature that's sort of similar to that one, but it's not a. Maybe until later on in the game you'll find it, but you know, chance of that coming is pretty low. So don't hope to see it though. That's all I'm gonna tell you right now. And even with Chrono's max out speed, it does that lock all spell pretty quick. So see, I already know I missed this one. Oh, come on. I'm gonna lose this one. Dead. Alright, good. We caught this one. Good. Beast Toss. That's a good technique to use. I think he's smaller. A bomb move, I think, Robo. Rick. I forgot I changed his name. Yeah, it's right in front of me every time I look at this damn game anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, arena bomb. Area bomb. There we go. Telsman's getting close. Getting close, guys. Getting close. Once we reach near the area that's close to no point of return, we're gonna go back. And see if this theory of mine is pretty accurate or not. Don't have much HP. Good. Down to 300. 12 points is not bad. I think at low point we're a tad bit overpowered. I think this is where it's gonna hit to the no return point here pretty soon. So we're gonna try to attempt to go back and forth because it's like there's three of them in the area. If they all pop back up again, it's easier getting their tech points from here. You need to fight those three more times and learn Tailspin. I meant to save. HP down. I think he should be dead. No, he's not dead. I know if you hit a certain amount of damage on those things, if you kill both the bird and the imp, at the same time, I think the tech points go up a bit more, I believe. But since we're playing the first run around this, that's gonna be a little difficult. At least until we actually get the try to remember where's the no return path at. I think this is the one where there's gonna be no return, I believe. I can be wrong. I think we might be able to do damage that can end them pretty quick. I just gotta see if it'll work or not. I could be wrong though, like I said, I could be wrong. But we'll have to check. Wrong enemy. They always hit the robot for some reason. She's getting close. Okay, I think that's the no end return point. Yeah, there's supposed to be someone else gonna fight. Oh, there's the number four, okay.
Run away from you, motherfucker.
There we go, I got the critical. Good. She's close. I think she like... let's see here. She was like 2-something. I see another, close to another 100 to go. Chrono's not too far either. Actually, let's go to that bridge far across there, and then turn back around. I think That's not work. Stupid plants. Okay, what I said earlier, those yellow demons, if we don't actually kill them fast enough, they do it as a special move that actually reduces your HP to 1. And you really don't want that to happen, trust me. Bye-bye. Love that move so much. It's so good. It's not great as triple raid or 3D attack. Still good enough. Kind of robot get confused. I don't get how that works. Okay, she learned her technique before we got to the other one. Alright, let's see how far we can go from here. If at least that certain part, one of the chain bridges actually turns dark, then we have to turn back. That's how I'm seeing it, so. Oh, speaking of which, here's another one of those things. Thank you. Guys, I am not watching the chat because I don't feel like taking my tablet slash or phone on me because I am tired. This is actually going to Ocean Palace is going to be a pain in the butt part. Okay, it's dead. Good. Luminary. Oh, great. It's gonna get complicated now. Oh, you stupid plants. Why are you blocking the way? Alright, you know what? I learned his ultimate attack, so we're gonna use it just because it's just there wishing to be used. I was gonna have a seizure. Please don't watch this. Let's hope it right. He learned all his tricks before he hits the crapper. So that's a shame. That's really a shame. And I'm gonna make a separate file. Keeping him, trying to get him back. That's another term for it. Well, I got at least one shelter in one of those. Okay. Is this the path of no return yet? Okay, I think up there is the path of no return. Use your ultimate attack. Like, I realized that Chrono Trigger's attacks, like the dual text and their triple text, they're very flashy. Very flashy. And there's nothing wrong with being flashy, what you do. You know, but, you know. I think sometimes it's a little overkill. I think this is the bridge of no return, so we're gonna save here, and we're gonna go back. I know you're like, why are we seeing this? Well, just keep in mind that if we get those rubber rock things back out, there's a good chance we can actually be able to get everybody's text before we actually make it to the Ocean Palace. Now let's see if these rubber things come out once we go all the way back in the pond.
They threw something at us. Sapphire wouldn't be there. I think it has. We have the path that go all the way back. Alright, we're gonna try to avoid battles if we can. Motherfucker, okay. Alright, let's try this and see if all the birds die from holding on to the captives. It didn't work, okay. Chrono can't learn anything no more. So that's a good thing. And a bad thing, because we have a slot that we can't use. At least until he dies. They go down! Sorry, guys. Oh, fire damage wasn't high enough. All criticals, guys. All criticals. No, we forgot that would have been a big problem for us later. An area about now. So, he's up to his ultimate attack with his Shaka. The Shaka. That's why only Chrono Robo only has two attacks, because the third dual attack actually is pretty good. Oh, it's called Shock. Aw. I think Shocker was actually a better name. Because I seen a revised name version of it, I think on the Super Nintendo version. Rock Squash. Thank you. as we go down from the mountain. Then I go back down to the lower level.
Yep. Because there was one time I tried this theory and it actually did pop up, but the rate of it pop up again is pretty slow. But like I said, we can't get, you know, most of our, like, at least a good amount of our characters get most of their points for their attacks, then we can always continue on from a different location to do that. So we're gonna go all the way back here. Those monsters will not come back, I believe. I could be wrong. Oh, there was something over there. I forgot I had that on me. I was like, why is Robo damage almost similar to everybody else's? I'm like, I forgot to equip him another weapon piece I got picked up from a previous quest. I'm just such an idiot sometimes. Okay. Let's go back out the mountain. The floating mountain, to be exact. So I just found out that I had to work on Sunday. And this is just not gonna be fun. That's a bit better. Alright, so far I don't see any of those rubbles anywhere.
Did I cross that bridge last time? I don't think we did. Yeah, I did, because that leads over there. The treasure chest is at. Oh, okay. Alright, we don't need to go that way. Alright, we're gonna go take this chain bridge. Leads up here. Go to the next area. Nothing over here. Doze off a little bit, guys. Sorry about that. At least my voice is not that loud. I hope I fixed up the problem. Keyword hope. I'm smart. I'm not gonna deal with that bull. Aw, damn it! I dozed off. It's usually bad idea to do this while you're partially asleep. Alright, jeez. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. I got a total of an hour and 2 minutes of gameplay right now. I am very silent because I'm trying to keep myself from going to sleep on you guys. Alright, so it looks like my theory, the rate it's as predicted from my emulation days, it's really bad. So we're gonna have to actually go this way. That way.
Gargoyles. Gargoyle.
Who makes up these names for these characters, these enemies? Do that. Did not really mean to do that. Okay. Alright, so on the Gods of Capture software, apparently there is no way I can tell if
man-eaters. Man-eaters. He's up. I didn't mean to hit Cyclone, but I just hit it anyway. Okay. So those rocks didn't pop up. And like I said earlier, I mean, it has happened before. The spawn rate of those things are really low. They give a lot of tech points. That's, I mean, it's obvious why they do that. So we're gonna skip it. Like I said, Chrono got his. These I have three characters that are close to the. That has learned their final attacks. Two characters are only on their second to final attack, and then we should be good. What I'm gonna do is we're gonna save over here and heal and save, then we're gonna go straight to the boss. Yeah, it's gonna be the boss, yeah. I know, because the chains are going to a strange spot. So, well, all the chains go to strange spots, but yeah. Oh yeah, it's one more area. I forgot about this area. Okay. Don't think there's any. No, yeah, there is enemies in this area. Time hat. Ooh, a time hat. Now this is actually a good equipment if you're trying to increase speed for certain characters. For example, a slow robot. In our group, certain slow robot in our group, Rick, is really slow. You should know that by now, guys. But for a highly intellect mechanical device, moves like a snail when it comes to like battling against other enemies and stuff. I wonder who's viewing this right now. Well, it is. Welcome to stream. I don't know who's on or what right now, because, you know, I don't have anything on me that. Oh, okay. Oops. No, that's not it. No. Okay. Yeah, so that helmet prevents you from slowing stop. So, we'll just keep it like the way it is for now. It's not really necessary for that yet, so. Moment of truth, guys. Boss time. You gotta love how some games repurpose certain things there. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the boss battle. So one of our guys here has a special equipment that is attached to him, which is known as a element armor, which actually he doesn't get damage much, so that's a good thing.
We don't have a red mail, which I wish we did, but we don't. So, that would definitely come handy. Well, here's the reason I put Robo with that particular equipment. Is because those two hands are dangerous right there when they work together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep using Falcon Hit in order to hit both targets at once. And while Robo does healing duty, which in theory it works pretty well. There were some points I used to, when I played this before, I used to actually had, when I had actually Frog with me with Ella and Chrono, because, since, you know, see? Easy peasy. Now he could do some damage here. And we're gonna keep using our best attacks here. Speed tap, sweet. We're gonna give that to Robo, since Robo is slow as shit right now. See, without the two hands, he cannot do much right now. Hands are back, see? I don't think Rockthorn will hit because he's a big enemy, but it won't hurt to check, right? It's a miss. Dead. Yeah, Ayla and Chrono, when they work together, that Falcon Hit does a lot great damage. It's like close to doing triple rare when you're fighting against Megas. That good. Is that good, so. I gotta get off that platform so we can rescue this guy. Recognize the guy? Interesting. It's falling. It's falling. Fall down. Dur. Great. This dumbass. He actually has a role into the sequel of this game. Well, not really sequel, but like, you know, the following up after this particular game. Not the one that came out in Japan, but the PlayStation game that came out that has sort of the same name as this particular one. So... gee, I wonder what the significance of a red knife would do. Even though it's made of the same materials, the damn machine that you guys used to create, to make, filter, cipher the energy off of the damn creature, the machine, you get the idea. Okay, so. So folks, here's something interesting. What I normally do, like just a... I usually bring this back with me. And from there, I get out. I get out and use the portals. Because at least with the portals, we're not too far from where we had to head for there. But something just when I played, used to play, something occurred that was pretty interesting, so. Now you're thinking to yourself, why are we going back without the Epa? Because, I hate to say this, but there's something weird that happens. Apparently, the Epa returns back right after you fighting in the Ocean Palace. And the death of Chrono. Yeah, new friend, she's gonna die. This part right here. And a lot of people actually, I know, that play this game, this is considered their least one of their least favorites. Had a guy that I watched stream also, one of his least favorite areas is the one with the prehistoric lair of that queen of the reptiles, whatever her name is, some weird name, but yeah, it's pretty unusual. Just I'm saying, it's pretty unusual. That shrine that we're not too far from, that happens to be the Sun Shrine. That particular shrine, we're gonna need to see during a event known as the side quest, the Sunstone side quest, which personally I think it's not really one of my favorites because of a certain boss you had to fight in order to obtain the stone itself. At least in its unpurest form, so unfully charged form. Sorry, not unpurest, unfully charged form. And I believe that just, you know, it's really unusual, you know. Don't mind me. I got something stuck between my teeth. Aha. Thank you. Now, if you guys are familiar playing with the DS version of this game, I think personally it's actually the most updated and better version of all the other ones that were made, including the re-releases on the PlayStation 3, the Wii. I think it was on the, it was never on the Xbox, was it? No, it was not on the Xbox. So yeah, it came out and I know it came out on the Wii. It will never come out on Wii U because it's a Square game. It came out also on the PlayStation 3, and it was also on the compilation pack twice. I think it's the Chronicles bundle for Final Fantasy, which that's the one I'm playing on right now. They may release that out twice. There is one version actually with the greatest hits on it, which actually has the newer updated CDs, which there are like, you know, basically not the ones with the black like back on it. But regardless, I don't recommend those the ones without the certain thing because they cause problems. Problems such as trying to load with an older model PlayStation 1, it doesn't work all the time and it craps out. So I'm not a big fan of that. Doing that. A save point here usually is not a good thing. Alright, so we're gonna have a rematch with this guy. They kidnapped the princess. Scarla. We're gonna do two save files, guys, because I want to try to at least do one play without Chrono and get that other crappy ending. I know that ending is like, it just skips everything after Larvals' death, but you know, there's a reason why it happened. But I know the true canon ending is when the mom goes missing and it just flies out. No, but this guy's an asshole. Just saying, this guy's an asshole. Alright. First thing step we're gonna do is confuse. Then after that, I have a feeling he's gonna do a lot of damage. Yep, he is. Let's see if we can get anything from this guy. Power meal. Hey, she didn't attack. What does a power meal do? I never actually stole from this guy before, just to be honest with you. I picked two of the wrong characters for this. Actually, no, he has area bomb. No, he has the area bomb, but gonna do a double attack. See, Rick doesn't have to worry about any issues with that because he has high health anyway to begin with. Now, right, guys, after this battle, we're gonna call it for tonight. Well, actually, for this morning, but you know. Hate that move. We're gonna go save and heal. Heal and save. And like I said earlier, we're just gonna call it for tonight because this recording slash stream, it's taking more than time it's supposed to be. I'm trying to do this play at least about an hour or so, because I gotta re-edit some stuff on YouTube in the process of it too. Which, yeah, fuck it. Yes, guys, I saved a bunch of times. Alright, guys. I bid you good night. And also, have a very